Seems like construction sites are a good place to look for some free woodlog. And when you find it, you can make awesome furniture like this. What I've made here is a woodlog bench. What I like about this log bench is it's got a simple form, it doesn't cost much, it doesn't take much effort to make it, and the most important thing of all, it kind of adds an attitude to wherever you place it. So why wait? Let's roll the intro and I'll show you how I made this log bench. Whenever a house is being built and if a tree comes in the way of their work, it's either removed fully or partially. If the wood has got some value, it is sold, or if not, it is simply discarded and left to rot. I got this log from a construction site and the idea is to make a bench using this log, and I'm trying to keep the log as natural as possible and work on a simple form. To proceed further, I have to split this log into two equal halves. I thought I could use the chainsaw attachment on the angle grinder, but something in my gut told me not to do it. So I took this log to the mill. When I went to the mill, I came to know that this wood, which comes from a neem tree, is a little bit harder for the bandsaw blades that were installed in their bandsaw. So I had to wait for about 2 hours till they finished their work, changed the blade, and then got to mine. This information meant only one thing to me. If I had used the angle grinder chainsaw attachment, chances are that it could have given me some serious kickback, or worse, the blades could have jammed, making work difficult. Another thing I realized later was trees in the city are hammered with a lot of nails and to hang posters, banners, cable lines and whatnot. When the tree grows, it engulfs the nail within itself, and by visual examination, it's really hard to tell if there is a nail embedded inside the log. Bigger machines in the mill can handle smaller nails, but smaller machines like this angle grinder chainsaw attachment is not going to stand a chance. So I guess it was the right decision to take it to the mill and get this job done. You can see that the wood log is cut into two halves and these two halves are not equal. It was not intentionally cut this way, but what I can do is use this bigger portion as a base and use the smaller portion for the shoulder rest. You can see that the cut that was made earlier using the chainsaw is not proper, it's kind of slant. It is going to come in the way of the work, so what I'm going to do now is remove this much of portion.
Getting a straight cut on this log is going to be difficult for me. The idea is to mark a line and then cut it using the chainsaw and holding the chainsaw as steady as possible when I make the cut. Securing the log with the clamp is very important. If it shifts during the cutting process, it could pinch the chains, giving it a serious kickback. Surprisingly, the cut was much cleaner when the log is clamped properly. Then I aligned the other half and made a matching mark and cut it to the matching size. We now have two pieces of the original log cut vertically and also in the same length. I am preparing for the next phase of the video. Don't expect everyone to have a shop vac. This log is almost 9 inches wide and the center part is almost 1.5 inches thick at the maximum. If this was to be made into a wooden plank, it could be strong enough to be the base of a bench even without any metal frame. For the frame, I'm using 1 inch by 1 inch square tubing. It's good to have some of these extra pieces cause they come in handy for marking, measuring and clamping. Measurements I'm using may not be very useful for you as I'm basing this entire thing on the log I found. But to give you a perspective, the foot of the bench will be 18 inches, the base will be 11 inches and the backrest will be 12 inches. This is how the frame is going to look like once completed. It will be made out of two pipes. The long pipe will be cut at two intervals and bent into this shape. Later, the other piece will be added. Maybe add some extra pieces to give extra support. So I cut the pieces for the long part of the frame. But before working on the workpiece, I tested my plan with the spare piece and it seemed to work. This may look like a miter cut of 45 degrees, but it is actually a couple of degrees lesser than a 45 degree. Now when I bend the pipe, you can see that it is not exactly 90 degree joint, but a little wider than that. This way we can be sure that the bench is not going to topple over. I did this bend on 18 inches mark on one side, left 11 inch gap for the base and made the other bend at the 29 inches mark on the other side. Welding joints do not somehow stay at the same angle because of the expansion and contraction of metal. So I've clamped both the pieces together and tack welded them and let it cool down. Then later, these joints were reinforced with more welding. half of the work is done and now I am going to attach the other legs. Like before, I repeated the process of clamping them together and welded them. With these two sides, that is all four legs, are complete. It would need a crossbar for support, which I will tackle later. Getting back to the log, I now need to cut grooves for the logs to sit on the frame. I assembled this quick jig for a circular saw to ride on. I made two parallel cuts to match the size of the metal tube I was going to use, which was 1 inch thick. The meat in between the two parallel cuts could be easily removed using a chisel. The tube can now be seated without much struggle. I figured out that doing multiple passes in between the parallel cuts helps knocking the material really quick. Although the log has uneven thickness, the depth of the groove is the same for both sides, which will make the top surface sit parallel to the ground. This groove needs to match with the other half of the log, and I used a spare piece of pipe to align it and mark the placement for the groove. It got dark in here and I could not film, but I added another piece of tube in between each pair of legs. The logs were set in place and after all the minor adjustments, I measured the length of the crossbar. Since the whole structure is made with the same tubing, the measurements were simple. This piece was welded to the frame. I reinforced all the joints till I was sure that the frame is strong enough. The rust you see on the frame is from the previous night's rain and can be easily removed with some steel wool. Then I spray painted the entire frame with matte black. The log is supposed to be held together with screws and I'm making holes for them on the frame. Once I placed the log, I realized that my impact driver was not able to reach it because there was no clearance due to the extra tubing I had welded. It was a tough call, but I did it anyways. The backrest was easy to screw though. That's it. The bench is still robust and clean even after a heavy rain. It is still wet and would need days or even a month to completely dry out. Maybe I can varnish it then or leave it as it is.
I hope you enjoyed this video and I love this project. I like projects that keep the natural form of the tree, and if you like it too, please share it in the comments below, share it with the world, and you have my high five already. And please don't forget to subscribe to my channel Video Epo. I will see you in another video very soon. Until then, bye-bye.